today, 14 months ahead of the assembly elections in Goa, the state got a fully revamped BJP government. 10 cabinet ministers were among the 24 sworn in, but not a single member of the Vijay Rupani cabinet was given a berth. It was completely changed. Even veterans like Nitin Patel, Bhupendra Chudasama, they were all shown the door. It was very clear that the idea was to come into elections with a fresh slate, but the Congress, the Aam Aadmi Party are also saying that this is an admission of defeat. Let's take this across to Sanju Verma, national spokesperson of the BJP, who continues with us. Dr. Amit Nayak, leader of the Congress, joins us as well. Sanju Verma, was there major anti-incumbency which you are now trying to wipe away with a Sabko Badal Dalunga new cabinet?
First and foremost, the prerogative to select the cabinet vests with the Chief Minister, in this case, Bhupendra Patel. And the second most important point, I don't think this has anything to do with giving a certificate to the erstwhile dispensation of Vijay Rupani. Both Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah have lauded him and his efforts over the last 4.5 odd years. The more important point to note, Padmaja, is the fact that the same people who thought that the BJP is going to lose seats in Lok Sabha 2019 from Gujarat, they were in for a nasty surprise when we won all the 26 Lok Sabha seats from Gujarat in the 2019 General Assembly election, mind you, with a vote share of a record 62.21%, highest ever in recorded history. Vis-a-vis the Congress,
yes,
which was there with a 32.1% vote share, but with zero seats. The moot point I'm trying to drive home is,
yes,
that while the Congress is good enough to gain a decent vote share, it is not able to translate that vote share into a winnability quotient in terms of number of seats. And I think therein lies the problem. You can have the acting president of Gujarat Congress, Hardik Patel, attracting crowds.
Okay.
He attracted crowds even in 2017.
No, no, but
remember, Padmaja,
but the real worry is the Aam Aadmi Party for you. And the kind of miracle they performed in the civic elections in Surat especially. The main area where the Patidar agitation took place. And that is where you've got your maximum ministers from, 6 out of 24.
May I finish?
Yeah.
I beg to disagree with you. I think you're absolutely wrong when you say a miracle. Excuse me. 27 seats Aam Aadmi Party got in Surat. But Padmaja, have you forgotten that they lost deposits in Ahmedabad, lost deposits in Rajkot, lost deposits in Bhavnagar?
No, but I'm talking specifically about Surat. They won 27 seats just on debut.
Okay, let me know. Please don't interrupt me. You have a bad habit of interrupting when you don't like the facts.
Because I'm talking about
Padmaja
Surat.
Does Padmaja Joshi know that while Aam Aadmi Party won 27 seats from Surat, what about the 59 seats where they lost deposits? Are you kidding me? 27 out of 584 seats. BJP won 472
okay.
out of 584
So you're
seats.
Saying there is nothing to worry about, despite the fact that in the last assembly elections, you had your lowest ever figure. Even in the assembly, you had 99, which is the lowest the BJP has won. You're still saying there
yes.
is no reason to worry?
Yes, I think that's a good question. Now I'll tell you why. No, a lot has flown under the bridge. I think the OBC bill, via the 127th constitution amendment, which was passed in the monsoon session,
okay,
I think that will be a game changer. Because since 2015, for the last 6 years, if there is one thing for which the Patidar community has been raising its voice,
okay,
it is that they want to be given OBC status. And I think this is a masterstroke by the Modi government, because now the Gujarat state, like all other states, will have the luxury to draw their own OBC lists. And don't forget, Padmaja, OBCs make up for 36% of the Gujarat electorate.
Okay, let me open this up to Dr. Amit Nayak. BJP ki pravakta keh rahi hai, darne ki koi baat nahi hai, ye sirf hum ek nayi shuruaat kar rahe hain. Dr. Nayak.
Abar, देखिए बीजेपी के जितने भी प्रवक्ता है वो एक जुमला बता रहे हैं कि जो लास्ट इलेक्शन में 2017 में 150 के पार, इस बार उनके जो भी गुजरात के प्रेसिडेंट है उन्होंने बोला 182 के पार, ये सब जुमले हम तो बार बार थे गुजरात से, गुजरात की जनता है हम इनको अच्छी तरह से जानते हैं। अगर आप पिछले तीन दिन का गुजरात का जो भी मीडिया देखते होंगे मैम, तो आपको पता चला होगा कि जो भी गुजरात भाजपा के नेता है वो बार बार एक ही चीज दोहरा रहे हैं कि हम बदलाव में मानते हैं, ऐसा भारतीय जनता पार्टी ही कर सकती है, हम नए नए लोगों को, युवा लोगों को चांस देना। आप पूरा मंत्रिमंडल का लिस्ट देखिए मैम, कोई 8 पास है, कोई 10 पास है, कोई 11 पास है। गुजरात पहले से ही शिक्षित स्टेट है, यहाँ एजुकेशन का बहुत महत्व है। और ये जो नया मंत्रिमंडल बना है मोदी जी का भाजपा का, आप देखिए कि कितने लोग उसमें एजुकेटेड भी नहीं अच्छी तरह से। दूसरी बात, अगर बदलाव में ही मानते हैं, ये लोग बोलते हैं कि हम बदलाव लाते हैं, अरे भाई आप लोग अगर बदलाव में ही मानते हो तो मोदी जी केंद्र में 7 साल से, उनकी कितनी नीतियां ऐसी है जिसमें वो फेलियर रहे, फिर वो जीएसटी हो, कृषि कानून हो, नोटबंदी हो, काला धन की वापसी हो, महंगाई की बात हो, बेरोजगारी की बात है, हर मुद्दे पे जो मोदी जी ने चुनाव के 2014 के भाषणों में बोला था उसमें से 90% से ज्यादा मुद्दों पे मोदी जी पहले और साबित हुए। तो भाई मोदी जी को आप क्यों नहीं बदल रहे हो,
बताइए मोदी जी के। संजू वर्मा,
मोदी जी
संजू वर्मा,
पद्मजा, द डिबेट इज ऑन गुजरात एंड आई विल स्टिक टू गुजरात। I don't think this man is important enough for me to dignify what he wants me to say. Debate Gujarat par hai aur main Gujarat par aapko sahi jawab deti hu. Can I please not be heckled? I think this is not fair. I did not intervene when this man was talking. Can I?
Just go on.
Yes.
Padmaja, we have always said this time again from various portals, and Prime Minister Modi has reinforced this ad verbatim. When we say sabka saath, sabka vikas, sabka vishwas, sabka prayas, it is not a platitude but an abiding work ethic. And I'll tell you why Gujarat will again vote for us despite a so-called anti-incumbency of more than 2 decades. Because today Gujarat has a GDP of over 17 lakh crore. Today, Ahmedabad and Vadodara are coming up as 2 very big pharmaceutical hubs in India. Surat continues to be the major textile hub. And one more thing, do you know, 20% of India's industrial production comes from Gujarat.
No, but Dr. Amit Nayak, COVID ki baat kar rahe hain. Aap industrial development ki baat kar rahi hain. Woh keh rahe hain ki aap pichle 12 mahine dekhiye. Woh aapko kuch aur aakar dena chahte hain. Dr. Amit Nayak. No, no, just a second.
I am not here to be dictated by what Amit Nayak says. Let me make my point. Please stop heckling me.
No, I am not heckling you. Let him also put forward his facts. Just a second. He wants to rebut you. I think he deserves to have his voice out.
I did not finish.
I have the last 2 minutes. Please let him have his counter. Then you can rebut. Dr. Amit Nayak, yes.
You did not allow me to finish.
Padmaja, ma'am se main ek hi sawal karna chahta hu. Ma'am, jis industry ki, Surat ke textile industry ki, जिस जीआईडीसी की आप बात कर रही हो, गुजरात में 50-100 सालों से जब कांग्रेस की सरकार चलती थी, आपको शायद गुजरात का स्वर्ण नहीं, आप लेट मी फिनिश फर्स्ट मैम,
प्लीज
मेरी बात सुन लीजिए मैम, मैंने आपको इंटरप्रेट नहीं किया, प्लीज मैम।
ओके संजू वर्मा,
खुद के मोदी जी हमेशा खुद के मन की बात करते हैं, खुद का विकास।
अच्छा संजू वर्मा को जवाब देने दीजिए, संजू वर्मा।
अरे मोदी जी सबकी बात,
कैन यू स्टॉप द बैकग्राउंड म्यूजिक,
गो ऑन।
I will talk about economic numbers because if you want to know why after 2 decades of being in power we are still so confident, it is because 20% of India's industrial production is from Gujarat, 20% of India's merchandise export.
No, but the question to you is, if you're so confident, why change? Isn't the change talking about anti-incumbency, or rather, in, you know, your fear of anti-incumbency? If you're so confident, why did you change? You should have gone in with the same people.
Okay, let me now answer that.
Yeah.
I want to ask you one thing. Why should we not change if we want to ensure that our chances of a victory are brighter? It is the prerogative of the concerned government, the concerned chief minister, the concerned party in the state, and the central leadership. We will do everything to ensure a winnability quotient which ensures that we come back to power. And
okay.
I want to ask you one thing. Congress ne to pichli baar Shankar Singh Wagela को ब्लेम किया था कि भाई हम 2017 में हार गए बिकॉज शंकर सिंह वगैरह लेफ्ट की पार्टी जस्ट ऑन द ईव ऑफ असेंबली इलेक्शन। प्रॉब्लम विद कांग्रेस इज राहुल गांधी इज इनकॉम्पिटेंट। जब तक राहुल गांधी है ये कोई इलेक्शन जीतेंगे नहीं, पर ये कड़वा सच ये लोग समझने के लिए तैयार ही नहीं है.
ओके, दैट इज, दिस इज नॉट अबाउट राहुल गांधी, दिस इज अबाउट व्हाट द चेंजेस इन गुजरात मीन, एंड इट इज बीन अ कंप्लीट 100% चेंज. आई एम अनफॉर्चुनेटली आउट ऑफ टाइम, बट आई थिंक वील हियर मच मोर अबाउट दिस, मोर डिटेल्स ऑफ द कैबिनेट एंड वेदर देर आर एनी वॉइसेज राइजिंग इन डिसेंट. फॉर द टाइम बिंग, संजू वर्मा, डॉक्टर अमित नायक, थैंक यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग मी.